Hi there, this is Jomi Thomas and today I will take you through the two most common rigs which I use for my fishing. Where and when do I use them and what are their benefits? So this is our first rig where we have a main line and to that main line we have a swivel attached to one end, and to the other end of the main line we have a leader line which is around 12 inches long, and we have a circle hook. This is a 6-aught circle hook. In between the swivel and the main line, on the main line I have a rolling swivel. The main line can easily move to and fro through this swivel, and to this swivel I have attached this fishing sinkers. Now these fishing sinkers, I have made them myself. If you would like to know how do I make this, I have put a link in the description to this video. Now let me tell you when and where do I use this kind of a rig. When I fish at spots where there are no snags, which means no sunken wood, sunken plastic waste or cloth waste in the riverbed, that is where I use this kind of a rig. And that is because in this rig, the hook, once casted, the hook touches the bottom. And this hook, if there are sunken weeds, sunken waste materials, this hook can get caught up in those weeds or logs, and I might lose my rig and a lot of my main line. So that is just one drawback of this rig, that you should not use this rig at places where there are snags. Now, this is one of my most favorite catfish rig. Let me tell you why. Now, when it comes to catfish, I use bigger hooks. That is because if the hook is small and the bait is small, what the fish would do is, fish would gulp that bait, and especially catfish will sit over that bait and keep chewing that bait until it reaches the gut. And that is when you gut hook the fish. And if you gut hook the fish, I feel it very hard to remove the hook. So that is one reason I use bigger hooks. These circle hooks, they tend to hook in the mouth of the fish and not at the gut. So when I use bigger hooks, I get to use bigger baits. And when it comes to bigger bait, the catfish, they'll gulp the bait, but they will not sit at the same place and keep chewing it. As soon as they have that big bait in their mouth, they try to swim away to their hides, carrying that bait. And when that happens, the circle hook gets hooked in the fish's mouth. Now, let me explain you why this kind of a setup, why this moving bait. Now, when this kind of a rig is casted, the fish takes the bait and tries to swim away. If the bait which I am using is static, there'll be a sudden stress to the string. And when the fish will feel that stress, it will spit out the bait and thereby you lose your fish. But when you're using such kind of a bait, this main line can easily move through this weight. So this weight will never add a stress to the line until the line itself is tight. This is why I use this rig when I go for catfishing. Now let us move to the second rig. Now this is the second type of rig which I use for my fishing. Now in this rig, if you see, there is a leader line tied to a swivel, and on the other end the main line, and in between the leader line there is a second line which is coming out, to which there is a hook attached, and this junction is a T junction. So let me tell you where and when I use this kind of a rig. So this is how this rig works. once you cast this rig, the weight will touch the bottom of the riverbed. But the hook, which is around halfway above this leader line, hangs on top and it doesn't touch the bottom. Thereby, it saves your hook from being caught up to the materials which are there sunken down in the riverbed. And this helps you save your hook, your weight and your main line, thereby saving your money and enjoying your fishing. I hope you like this video and it will help you in your fishing. We'll see you soon in my next video. Till then,
bye!
Goodbye!